by profession. And today we are going to talk about how can graphology help in areas of psychology, or how psychology is connected to graphology. Can anybody tell me what is psychology?
Study of the mind.
Study of the
mind.
Yeah, study of the mind in what sense? As in, what can you study of the mind?
Externally, whatever possible.
Okay, study behavior. And somebody said?
Response of mind.
Response of the mind. Okay, and?
Aptitude.
Aptitude, right. Who goes to a psychologist?
Basically, students can go to
IQ testing, aptitude test. IQ is what? Your intelligence level. You know, how much intelligence quotient you have.
Mental disorders and disorders.
Mental disorders. Okay. OCD and all those things.
Depression.
Right. Now, what we are trying to do basically is, I'll divide this seminar in two parts. One is, I'll tell you what is graphology. And second is, how graphology can be used to find out whatever we spoke right now. The IQ, the aptitude, the psychological disorders, the intelligence level, or the behavior, or whatever other things you saw. So graphology is basically a science to understand the human brain from the handwriting. Sounds interesting, right? So we have an ECG. We all are aware of an ECG. You know, when you connect the ECG to the heart, on paper, what comes is the state of the heart, right? What's happening in the heart, we see on the paper. So, graphology is actually what's happening in the brain, you know, comes onto the paper through your writing. So, if ECG can tell you problems in the heart, handwriting can actually tell you problems in the mind, you know. So, problems would be all these things, like, you know, psychological disorders. Those are weaknesses. We can also find out the strength in the person, the behavior, the honesty, the integrity.
Can you build this as a pattern?
As a pattern of human behavior. Give me an example. As a what?
Like, as you said, graphology can study a person. But study a person means the person, you put the person in the particular pattern.
Yeah, so what is psychology? Psychology is basically understanding the human pattern. Right? So, you know, if you tell me that you are a lonely person, so I automatically understand you have less strength. So it's a pattern. Maybe you are introvert also. Maybe I can think that. Right? So it's a pattern. We feel there are so many different people in the world. It's not like that. You know, there are only few patterns in the world. And everybody falls in the same pattern. Now let me tell you something about graphology. Graphology is about analyzing handwriting and understanding the traits of a person. Okay? Let me show you something. Whom do you think is a simple person?
Left.
A.
Whom do you think is a simple person?
A.
Who said B? But why do you say A?
Because it's visible. It's readable.
It's very clear.
It's very clear, right? It's readable, right? You can read what he's writing, you know, or he's not creating a effort to hide something. Okay. So if this is clear, then this is complicated, right? Now, why is a person liking something that is complicated? Or why is a person choosing a signature which is complicated? Or why does he feel that my signature should be complicated?
He doesn't want to bring all his
He doesn't want to get identified.
He feels that he don't copy his signature.
Oh, copy secondly. Copy, I'll tell you what is the factor. But when you start liking complicated things, you know, or you should start choosing complicated things, then you are actually a complicated person.
Yes.
But there are also some people who
know
basic
things
about the technology, they try to do this on their own. That's also
right.
That's also why
Okay, I'll come to that. That's called graphotherapy. Change your handwriting and change yourself. But what I'm telling you is we have a sixth sense. You know, see, no, very few people must be knowing about graphology here. But everybody says A is a person who is simple. So there is some kind of gut feeling. There's some kind of, you know, sixth sense which tells you that this person should be simple. Why? Because he's liking simple things. If a person likes simple things, then he should be simple. That is the subconscious understanding, the subconscious decoding of this. And if the person is choosing to sign complicated, that means he must be having a complicated way of thinking. Okay. See, anything that happens in the world happens twice. Do you agree with this?
Never.
Anything that happens in the world happens twice. Do you agree with me?
Yes.
It has to carry some change.
It has to
carry some amount of change. The visual or not.
What?
First here and then next.
This seminar happened twice.
See, once in the mind and once in actual this weekend. That way you can say it happens twice. Otherwise things are happening.
N number of
once.
But it has to happen twice. You know, once in your mind and again in the reality. Now the problem is, unless it happens in your mind, it can never happen in reality. You know, like if you are not decided in your mind that you will be here at 3:30, you wouldn't have been here at 3:30, right? So that decision you have created first, the seminar was actually created in your mind whenever you decided to come here. Now, unless it has happened in the mind, it will not happen in the real life. And the best part is, it will ask for your permission. Should I make it happen? You know, your conscience actually asks you, right? Do you really want to go to this seminar? You said yes. Then the decision happened, and then it happened in real life. Okay. Now, when we say a person like a complicated signature likes things complicated, so what kind of things will happen in his life? Complicated, right? Because we are doing in psychology also, what we are doing, we are analyzing the character of the person. In graphology also, we are analyzing the character of the person. When we analyze a character, there is a process. If a person has positive thoughts, he'll talk positive words. If a person has negative thoughts, he'll talk negative words. If a person talks negative, what kind of action he will take? Negative.
Obviously, right?
If you do one action continuously, it becomes a habit. And a set of habits is actually
character,
right? So from a character, when we are analyzing a character, we are actually analyzing what?
The thought process.
If you have a person with negative character, that means his thought process is negative. If a person has good character, his thought process is positive. Okay. So this is the thought process actually. This is a good thought process and that is a bad thought process. Now coming to the obvious question which all you have asked, like, I don't want other people to duplicate my signature. Okay. If you put one lock to your safe, that is necessity, that is confidence. If you put two locks to your safe, what is that?
Insecurity.
Insecurity.
Okay, that is insecurity, right? So the moment the thought comes to your mind that somebody is going to duplicate my signature, and that's the reason I should make it complicated. What does that show?
You want to lock?
Insecurity.
Exactly. So this person actually says, why should anybody duplicate my signature? Let me sign it simple. And this person will say, there are hundreds of people even just waiting to duplicate my signature. So I have to make it more complicated, more complicated. So what is the thought behind it? The thought is insecurity, right? The thought is hiding. The thought is not being open. The thought is not generosity and all of that. The fact is, the most successful people in the world who are honest, I repeat, the successful people who are honest, very rare combination. You know? These kind of people will always have simple signatures. Okay. You see all the governors on the note, you can read the signature. You see Bill Gates, Amitabh Bachchan, Sachin Tendulkar, Ratan Tata, all these people successful and honest, right? You can read the signature. When you are honest, you have less insecurity. So you are comfortable signing a simple signature. You see Ratan Tata's signature, right? It's very legible, you can read it. He doesn't have a problem that somebody will duplicate my signature. Why? Because he's not insecure. Why do you say that?
Because anybody can copy the signature and cause any trouble. So that person is actually insecure.
Then why is it not changing the signature? Why is it not changing the signature?
Actually, someone else.